Lights, camera, action!
A few weeks ago, somebody left a comment on one of my videos. They posted, "I saw an interview with this guy on Film Courage, yet I see videos here of him being a struggling writer looking to get discovered. What gives?"
It's been a long time, I shouldn't have left you without a strong rhyme to step to. Think of how many weeks shows you slept through. Time's up, I'm sorry I kept you. Thinking of this, you keep repeating your miss. The rhyme from the microphone soloist. So you sit by the radio, hand on the dial soon. As you hear it, pump up the volume. Dance with the speaker till you hear it blow. Then plug in a headphone, cause here it go. It's a four-letter word.
What up, friends? Your body to dance. I've decided it's time to start making videos again. To paraphrase from the great Rakim, it's been a long time. I shouldn't have left you without a dope video to watch. It has been a long time. I've decided that it's time to make videos again. So here we go. Alright, so let me just go ahead and start off by addressing that comment. That comment came from JoeBiden105. It's pretty funny. Pretty funny. But you know, they say, yeah, you know, I come to this channel and I see videos of this guy struggling to get discovered. Yes, bitch! Getting discovered is a struggle. I feel like anyone that has any sort of screenwriting aspirations, filmmaking aspirations, you know, any sort of creative aspirations or dreams, know that getting discovered is a struggle. The thing about screenwriting, and I'm saying screenwriting here, screenwriting is difficult because, you know, we are trying to craft the story and everything, whatever. But a lot of screenwriters, I think, like, that's their creation. The screenplay is the creation. So it's not like a lot of people who, oh shit, it's not like a lot of people who are looking to be screenwriters are also looking to, like, make something. Now, for those who are, I shouldn't say I'm not considering them, but they're not solely screenwriters, right? They're filmmakers, you know, they really aspire to direct, or, you know, maybe become a DP or an editor or something along those lines. But there are people who just want to write. And to be honest, I, for a long time, have been that person where I just want to write. I just want to write. I just want to write. And so writing and then trying to get people to read your work, trying to get people to recognize that this is what you do, this is your specialty, you are a writer, that is difficult. That is a motherfucking struggle. You hear me, Joe Biden 105? It's difficult. It's a struggle. And the main reason it's a struggle is because nobody wants to read. Nobody, baby. At the end of the day, that's what it is. Nobody wants to read. This is why we have things like log lines. This is why production companies and studios and everything, this is why they have readers to provide coverage. The coverage is for the decision makers. So they hire people to do the job that they don't want to do, give their opinion as to whether or not it's a good idea, and then they make a decision off that. Nobody wants to read. Nobody wants to read. I swear to God, nobody wants to read. So that right there is just, that's a big barrier. But yeah, it is definitely a struggle. And this whole, like, YouTube thing that I'm doing, half of why I'm doing this is to document my journey. So that means I gotta document the struggle because I haven't made it to the other side yet. So yes, you are going to see me struggle to get discovered until I am discovered. I won't be struggling to do that anymore. And you know, the other thing, I know it might come as a shock to some of you because you very likely saw me interviewed on another YouTube channel. And like I'm trying not to name drop them so much because I don't want it to seem like, you know, like I'm trying to continually like ride their coattails or, you know, like that's my only claim to fame or whatever. But the thing is, you know, they discovered my channel, they saw me, they saw my content, and they liked what I was presenting. They liked my story and felt that my story could probably help other people who are struggling to get discovered. So to answer your question, Joe Biden 105, that's what gives. That's what gives. So on the life front, I was recently diagnosed with sleep apnea. So You will hear me talk about like my snoring in a future video because I made that video before I'm making this video and I refer to my snoring. But yeah, you know, like honestly, for years now, people have just been like, yeah, your snoring is bad. So I mentioned this to my doctor on you know, at a recent checkup. He was like, well, let's go ahead and set you up with a sleep study to see if you may potentially have sleep apnea. And underwent the sleep study, which was a whole involved thing. And yeah, I got the results, like the test results back. And then today, like, you know, everyone was hitting me up. My doctor was hitting me up. The people from the Sleep Institute or whatever, they were hitting me up. And everyone's just like, this shit is serious, Jay. Let's get this taken care of, like, ASAP. So I have an appointment next week, early next week, I guess, just to see what you know, what we can do. But yeah, I'm none too happy to report that I have yet another chronic condition to deal with. And I'm gonna tell y'all, I know that this is all stemming from my younger days when I was like really, really like drinking heavily and wilding out. I know it seems like I might drink a lot and go out a lot now. When I tell y'all I have calmed that shit down, I really have. Like, I don't drink nearly as much as I used to, like, not even like 5 years ago. You know, I'm just letting y'all know, it's fun. It's fun. I fucking love it. But, you know, some of the consequences. Sleep apnea. So I'm dealing with that. Still trying to regulate my blood pressure. Still trying to lose weight because I'm nice and overweight. You know, shout out to the people who are just like, oh, you carry it well. Nah, fam, I gotta get rid of this shit. So, I've been working on doing that. So, hopefully, lose this weight, cut down on like the drinking, cut down on like the poor eating, like eating out, when I like fast food. And quite honestly, I've been doing a great job of that. But yeah, fam, shit is no bueno. No bueno. Try to live long enough to get discovered. And as far as writing goes, I finally finished Azalea. And yes, it sucks. It is as terrible a first draft as any first draft. I mean, you know, that's the thing is that I had to learn to let go of this perfectionist thing that I have. I'm a Virgo, so that perfectionism is in me. And so I just had to just let it go and just be like, you know what? This script is not going to be perfect in this first draft. So just get it on paper. You can always go back and refine it. You can always go back and tweak things and whatever, whatever. So, that's my plan. It's done. The reason I haven't like sent it out to people who've asked for it is because I want to sit on it for a while, then go back to it, work on it a little more, make sure that it's not the piece of shit that it is right now, and then I'll get it out. Another thing that I'm gonna do, I'm gonna submit a script to the Nickel Fellowship. There's something that I want to talk about the Nickel Fellowship, especially given a recent discussion on Twitter that took place about the Nickel Fellowship, but I'm going to save that for another video. But in this one, I'm just going to say I am planning on submitting a script. I don't know which one yet. There are two scripts that I want to submit, that I'm thinking of submitting rather, because I think this is the first year where they've like capped like the amount of the number of entries to like one. Number one, they're only accepting 5,500 scripts total. So there's that. And then each entrant can only like enter one script. So I need to really decide which script I want to enter. And it's either my raunchy romantic comedy or my adventure comedy. Don't know which one. Don't know which one. I'm gonna figure that out, and then I'll enter it. But again, I'm gonna talk about that in depth, in detail, in another video. So that's really about it, friends. That's what I got. That's what gives. And yeah, like I said, I'm back in my video bag, so I'm just gonna just start making shit and uploading shit. My man Saeed, he's just like, he thinks that, these conversational style videos work for me. Quite honestly, this is easier because I could pull out the big camera, but fam, busting this out and trying to vlog with this shit right here. It's doable, but it's a lot of work. So I would much rather do what I'm doing right now. It's a lot easier. I can just probably pump out some stuff a lot quicker. So there you go. So that's about it for this one. I'll see y'all in the next one. I know my buddy Jason hates this cap. I gotta represent, bro. Oh man, oh man.